Do you know what the best aspect ratio for your photo is? Hi everyone, in this video we're going to be taking a look at aspect ratios. I'm going to explain what they are, some of the common aspect ratios you've probably already come across, and why it's good to be familiar with them. Let's go check it out. Aspect ratios tell us the ratio of the sides of our photos or videos. It's not the specific size of the image, but the ratio of the sides to each other. For example, the width and height. Aspect ratio is shown as two numbers, and the first, of course, indicates the width, and then the second one is going to reflect the height. So what does all this actually do? Well, most of the time, aspect ratios are a good thing when it comes to printing, but we can take advantage of them, and they're useful when it comes to the digital sphere as well. Now, it's important for printing because it tells us whether or not we need to crop our photo or if the entire image fits in the frame. Digitally, aspect ratios are useful for social media like Instagram, where a different aspect ratio is used for posts and a different one is used for stories or reels. Now let's take a look at some of the most commonly used aspect ratios. So 3:2 is the standard format for photography. And by default, virtually every camera is set to a 3:2 aspect ratio, and that's no accident. The 35mm film frame has an aspect ratio of 3:2, so most prints are adapted to this ratio. And if you want your photos to have a different aspect ratio than your camera, you're gonna have to adjust it in the settings. Now 16:19 is the standard widescreen format used for television broadcasts or video. Full HD, 4K, and other formats use this ratio as well. And recently, the vertical 9:16 aspect ratio has been used, especially for social media sites like Instagram or TikTok. Now 4:3 was the earlier standard format for broadcast TV, and this format virtually disappeared with CRTVs. And today you can only use it in specific cases or if you want to simulate the look of a TV from the CRT TV era. Now 1:1 is a square, which is used for social media, especially Instagram and for feed posts. And this aspect ratio also has its place in print since square pictures are a timeless form of media. Now, how do you set your desired aspect ratios for your photos? The easiest way to do this is to use cropping. If we click on crop and in the right panel, we can set the desired aspect ratio either with the preset ratios or by entering the ratio manually. And the crop is then set to that ratio and we can now crop how we want without worrying about the image not fitting after exporting. Now to get the correct ratio in the print module, simply select the desired template. Zonar Photo Studio X adds the photo, then you double click to adjust how the photo is cropped. But you have to remember that if you don't have the photo cropped to the right aspect ratio, the whole photo won't fit on the canvas. Now, in addition to all these existing formats, there's also plenty of other options to get creative with. And I'm sure many of you have heard of anamorphic lenses. And to take a look at this, let's jump into the world of videography or film. After the big boom in television broadcasting in the 1950s, filmmakers had to compete to bring audiences back to movie theaters. And the answer, along with color and surround sound, was widescreen. Now, several technologies emerged, but there was one that simply stuck, and that was CinemaScope. CinemaScope could be shot on standard 35mm film and only used special anamorphic lenses for the camera and attachments for the projector's optics. These squeezed the widescreen image into a standard 35mm frame while filming, then stretched it into widescreen again when projected. There was no need for major investments in technology for studios and especially movie theaters. Now the film industry uses a slightly different system for naming aspect ratios, and the ratio is always 2:1. The previous aspect ratio of 1:37:1 was standardized by the Academy of Motion Pictures, and it was then expanded to 2:35:1 and later 2:55:1. And this is exactly what anamorphic lenses do. They squeeze a widescreen image into what we're shooting using what's called a squeeze factor. Say we're shooting in 4K with an aspect ratio of 16:9 or 1:78:1, a lens with a squeeze factor of 1:33 times takes us from 1:78:1 to roughly 2:4:1. Now, to display the image correctly, it needs to be stretched, and the squeeze factor tells us how to do this, but we won't get into that in this video today. If this is something that interests you and you want to learn more about anamorphic lenses and widescreen and that sort of thing, let us know in the comments below and we'll think about doing something for you. Now, if I want to crop some of these film formats from a normal photo, there's nothing easier than multiplying the aspect ratio by 100 and entering the number into the fields for crop ratio. You have to multiply it by 100 because these fields are not set up to accept decimals. And that is it for aspect ratios. I hope it was something you enjoyed. Let us know what you think below. Thumbs up, subscribe, and I'll see you guys in another video some other time. Till then, take care. Have a good one.